हेलो, स्क्रीन इज विजिबल?
यस सर।
ओके, सो सॉरी फॉर लेट फ्रॉम माय साइड. सो देयर वाज प्रॉब्लम विथ प्रीवियस लिंक, सो आई हैव क्रिएटेड न्यू वन एंड शेयर्ड इमीडिएटली. सो आई विल स्टार्ट, आई विल ट्राई टू स्टार्ट लेक्चर एट राइट टाइम हियर आफ्टर. सो जस्ट I will revise so whatever things in last two lectures which we have discussed that we are going to review. So this unit content already I have told, then these are the books. So assignment questions, so we examination is based on the descriptive type, or descriptive type questions will be there. Then such questions will help you to understand the model question paper type. Then these are the objectives with respect to the first chapter, first unit. So here we have defined automobile engineering classification, to list various components of automobile, to describe the functions of components of the automobile. Then these are the outcomes which we have discussed. So after completing this unit, students will able to apply knowledge of different layouts of automobile and apply knowledge of different types of body and its construction for the automobile. So in introduction we have seen already these points, so I'm not going to repeat on the purpose. So this we have taken during yesterday's lecture. Based on the purpose, passenger carriers, where cars, jeeps, buses, then goods carrier, there are trucks. Then on the basis of fuel used, there are petrol vehicles, again motorcycles, scooters, cars, diesel vehicles, trucks, buses, etc., electric vehicle which use battery to drive. And now that scenario is started, and many manufacturer, many companies, many standard brands of vehicle, they are manufacturing electric vehicle, and there is huge competition. Then with respect to the steam vehicle, where steam is used and prime mover is in the form of steam engine, and gas vehicle, LPG and CNG. Then heavy transport vehicle, so just I have elaborated that short form into the long form. Heavy motor vehicle, HMV, for example truck, buses, those comes under heavy transport or heavy motor vehicle. Then light transport vehicle, under that category pickup, station wagon, etc., and light motor vehicle under that category cars, jeeps, etc. Then on the basis of construction or the body, how body is constructed. So sedan with two door, four door, that long car having two doors or having four doors. Then station wagon, that then convertible, so we can remove the roof. Then vans, then special purpose vehicle, ambulance, milk van, etc., and articulated vehicles. So tractors, container, carrier. So those we are being observing on the roads. Then on the basis of number of wheels and axle. So two wheeler vehicle, three wheeler vehicle, four wheeler vehicle, six wheeler vehicle. Then on the basis of transmission, conventional vehicle with manual transmission, car with five gears, semi automatic transmission, all British vehicles, those are coming under this category. And automatic transmission changes as per the speed of the automobile. So whatever the transmission shift itself automatically with the help of sensors, various sensors, and that works on the speed only. Okay. On the basis of position of engine in the front, most of the vehicles have engine in the front. Example, most of cars, buses, trucks in India. Engine in the rear side, so very few vehicles in India wherein engine is located in the rear end or at the rear side of the vehicle. So example is nano car. Then major automobile components and their functions. So already this we have started. So just a brief review I have given, just it is an repetition. So we need to remember this and may be useful for your final examination. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, major components. So yesterday we have taken it in somewhat hurried manner. So just I would like to elaborate this. So again, for your information, just I want to show this is the chassis. So you can see this is the six wheeler. So two wheels at the front and four wheels at the rear. And this is called as a chassis. So this image is displayed. Now we can see various components here. So here you can see engine. Just see the cursor highlighter. Then this one is the steering system. This one is the radiator. And this is chassis frame. This one is chassis frame. And this is exhaust system. And here, so you can zoom out the view, whatever you are observing. Then this one is the propeller shaft. This is final drive. So this image I have displayed intentionally to get an idea what is exactly the chassis. So chassis is nothing but vehicle without frame, without body, without body. So this is the chassis and which can be propelled from one place to another place. So number of times we have seen such vehicles while traveling on the road. So we are traveling in our own car or maybe car which we have taken on rent. So we are observing such vehicles without body, and that is called as a chassis. So this chassis is formed by frame having side members and cross members. Now we'll see this diagram. So this one is the top view. We can see here. This is chassis frame. So please understand, just I am moving cursor on that. So it is formed by a side members. So this is frame. This is called as a side member. This one is called as a side member. And this is called as a cross member. This is called as a cross member. This is called as a cross member. and this one is called as a cross member. So chassis frame is usually made up of box or somewhat tabular components or C channels. So just for your understanding, so this is called as a C channel, this is called as a box, and this is called as a I channel, right? So chassis is made up of C channel, sometimes with tabular, or the component having tabular tube like structure, or we can call in other word it as a box. These components or these long members and short members are riveted together. So why riveting is done? To get the rigidity. So if we are going to have the welding to some of the components, then their durability and strength is going to be decreased somewhat. So wherever possible, that riveting is done. So this chassis consisting of springs along with the axle and steering system, then engine, then fuel tank, exhaust system, radiator, battery, and other accessories. And this chassis is going to support the body. So this is called as a chassis. Samajh laga? Understood? ऐकू येते का माझा आवाज?
येस सर,
येते ना? ओके.
हा सर, तुमचा माइक म्यूट झाला वाटतं.
वन मिनिट. ओके. सो दिस इज अ ब्रीफ अबाउट द चॅसिस अँड हियर इट इज क्लिअरली मेन्शन्ड व्हेकल विदाउट बॉडी इज नोन ॲज चॅसी. व्हेकल विदाउट बॉडी इज नोन ॲज चॅसिस. ओके. सो चॅसी doesn't mean only the frame. Okay. And we can define it in other way as well. The skeleton of motor vehicle consisting of a steel frame supported on spring that hold the body and the motor. So this is nothing but the chassis. Okay, then next component, that is engine, or we can call it as a prime mover. Engine, or we can call it as a prime mover. So this engine is the power plant which is employed on the vehicle to have source of energy. So generally engine internal combustion engine with petrol or the diesel fuel is used to run the vehicle or is used to provide the power or source of energy for the vehicle. So that engine may be two stroke or maybe four stroke. So that engine, you know, it consists of cylinder, piston, valves and operating mechanism. So carburetor. And you in modern cars, it is multi-point fuel injection. So that is MPFI in modern cars. And the components of engine also include fan, then fuel feed pump, oil pump, etc. And sometimes it consists of ignition system for burning of the fuel in case of the petrol engine. So this is about the engine. So in short, engine or power plant or the prime mover, one and the same. So engine itself is called as a power plant, internal combustion engine with petrol or diesel fuel, two stroke or the four stroke. Okay. Then third major components. Here we are discussing only the major components. So third component, that is nothing but the clutch. So engine we have completed, then the clutch. So what is clutch? So the clutch is used to connect and disconnect, or is used to couple and decouple the engine and the transmission system. So when clutch is in engaged position, so here it is mentioned clutch. Clutch means pakadne, right? To grab. That is the meaning of the word clutch. So engine power flows to the transmission through it. So whenever clutch, that means grab. So whenever engine is in connection with the transmission system, at that time we can say that clutch is in operation. So generally whenever we are asking somebody so to press the clutch, that clutch pedal, that means we are declutching. We are declutching. So basically when clutch is in engaged position, the engine power flows to the transmission through it. And whenever we have to change the gears while vehicle is running, we need to declutch so that it can permit temporary decoupling of the engine and wheels so that gears can be shifted. So you can see this diagram. This is the engine output shaft. This one is the flywheel. And you can consider this is the plate inside the clutch housing. And we are going to connect these two rotating plates. This one is at its one place. Just we are pressing the clutch. That means we are moving this plate in this direction. So clutch means clutch is in always in engaged position. Clutch is in engaged position. So we are pressing the clutch. That means we are declutching. So it is necessary sometimes to interrupt the flow of power before gears are changed. Before gears are changed. For that, clutch is required. So clutch permits temporary decoupling of engine and the wheels. And in case of the scooter or bike, the clutch is operated by hand, whereas in case of cars, the clutch is operated by foot. Or in some scooties that there is centrifugal clutch. So only brakes are provided. So automatically that connection and disconnection between the clutch, between the engine and the transmission system is done via with the help of the centrifugal clutch or that fluid coupling in some of the cases. Okay. Then next component that is related to the gearbox. So this is the gearbox. This one is the gearbox. So So this one is the transmission. You can check figure at the right top. Here you can see, here it is written transmission system. So engine we have completed. This one is the clutch housing. Then, so because you should know these layouts, and intentionally I have displayed on the screen. There is sometimes the interviewer is asking question that tell the location of clutch. So clutch is in between engine and the transmission, or list the sequence of various components in the automobile. In that case, such diagrams are useful. So engine, after the engine we have seen the clutch and then the transmission system. So whatever power developed by engine, it should be transmitted to the transmission system, or it should be transferred to the transmission system so that wheels can rotate. So that power generated in engine via this clutch through this transmission system, it is provided to the wheels. Okay, so power developed by engine is transferred to the wheels by transmission system. So functions of transmission system is to provide varying gear ratio. So based on how many gears that manufacturer is desired to provide for a particular version, so number of gear ratios equal to number of gears in the vehicle. So to provide a reverse gear for moving vehicle in reverse direction, that is also function of transmission or transmission box or gear box, one and the same. Again, as I have said, clutch is in engaged position all the times. Now one more requirement of the transmission system is to provide a neutral or disconnecting arrangement so that engine can be uncoupled from the wheels of the vehicles. So clutch is in engaged position, and if vehicle is in neutral gear or neutral transmission, then we can decouple with the help of that neutral gear. So for that also clutch is required. So in conventional transmission system, there is clutch, a manually operated gearbox, a propeller shaft, and the final drive. So this one is the transmission. Then this drive shaft is nothing but the propeller shaft, and these two are universal joint. Then this one is the differential and the rear wheel. So this is about the transmission. Then next component that we are going to see, that is transmission. Already we have covered this gear as well. Then we are going to check about the, okay, so this is a large pictorial view for the transmission system, engine, clutch, transmission, that is gearbox, propeller shaft, rear wheel, and inside this final drive and the differential. Okay, so this is gearbox. Here, this one is the gear lever, and we can see 5-speed transmission. So, first gear, second gear, third gear, fourth third gear, fourth gear, fifth gear, and the reverse one. So, at least as a mechanical engineer, how gears can be shifted? So, first, it is in the forward direction. Immediately in the same line, there is second gear, and this line is nothing but here just we are ensuring that vehicle is in neutral gear. This is called as a neutral line where we are ensuring that vehicle is in the neutral. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and reverse. So gearbox contains gearing arrangement to get different speed. Then gears are used to get more than one speed. Okay. So gears are used to get more than one speed ratio in typical car. So there may be 6 gears including one reverse gear. So 5 forward. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this one is the reverse. So there may be 6 gears including one reverse gear. So 5 forward and 1 reverse. So you should remember, or just you can see here, first gear gives low speed but high torque. So that torque speed relation you might be knowing. So first gear gives low speed but high torque. Higher gears give progressively increasing speed. Accordingly, torque is going to be decreased. So gears are engaged and disengaged by shift lever. So this is the top view. We can see the top view of that gear lever. Okay. Then next one is, that is the final drive. So this is nothing but the final drive. So arrangement, this bevel pinion and the crown is nothing but the final drive. So final drive is last stage of transferring power from engine to the wheels. So here you can see engine, and these are the wheels, and this one is the last stage in transferring power from engine to wheels. So the function of this final drive to reduce the speed of the propeller shaft, that is drive shaft, to that of the wheel. So for example, we can take one example. So here, this is the flywheel. It is running at 2000 RPM. Then with the gearbox, we have reduced speed up to 500 RPM, any gear. Then propeller shaft is going to rotate with 500 RPM. And now that speed we need to reduce with the help of this pinion and crown wheel. And ultimately we can have speed of this 100 RPM for the wheels. So how it can be made? With the help of this bevel pinion and the crown wheel. So Thereafter, there is no change in the speed. So this one is the final stage of the transmission system. So differential is getting the speed of this 100 rpm, and relatively that speed we are going to differentiating for the for negotiating the turn without skidding. So just check out this. So final drive is the last stage in the transferring power from engine to the wheels. It reduces the speed of the propeller shaft or the drive shaft to that of the wheel. So this may be asked for MCQ. So this is important. Then it diverts the drive of propeller shaft by an angle of 90 degree to the drive wheels. So we need to rotate the wheels, which are mounted on the axle, which is perpendicular to the propeller shaft. So how to divert that power? For that, we are going to use the final drive, or final drive is required, and it is one of the requirement of the transmission system. So final drive, there are two types. One may be chain type and another may be gear type. So chain type, so whatever final drive for the bikes, so we can have chain and sprocket type final drive. And with respect to the vehicle, there is gear type of the final drive. Samajhte ka? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
One minute. Okay. So again, in bicycle, you might have seen chain and sprocket. That is also final drive. So chain type of the final drive. So that axle, so just we are pedaling at the front, and that is rotating, and we are having that chain type of final drive at the rear side. Okay. Then next one is okay. So next one is brake system. That is also major component of the chassis. So chassis is moving on the road. How to apply the brake to stop the chassis? So for that we require brake system. So actually brake mechanism is provided inside this wheel drum, or maybe disc. So what are the functions of the brake? So brakes are used to slow down and stop the vehicle. So brakes are used to slow down the vehicle and stop the vehicle in places, crowded places. So then hydraulic brakes are generally used in the automobile. So these brakes are applied with the help of that Pascal's law, the principle on which these brakes are working. So brakes are applied by pressure on the fluid. So there is master cylinder and the wheel cylinder. So that arrangement we are going to study in the brake system. So these brakes are operated with the help of brake lever. So for the bike, on the left hand side there is clutch lever, and on the right hand side there is brake lever near the accelerator, and we are applying brake by foot. So that brake pedal is there for the bike. Or sometimes, or it is there, hand brakes and parking brakes usually a mechanical brakes. So driver, left side of the driver, that hand brake is located and it can be operated with the help of hand. That's why we can call it as a hand brake or parking brake, or another name we can call it as a emergency brake. So used for parking the vehicle on slopy surfaces and also in case of the emergency. Okay, then steering system. So already we have seen this diagram. So this is the steering. Here this one is the steering wheel. This is steering wheel, steering gearbox, and this one is the linkage for the steering. This is linkage for the steering. So front wheels can be turned to left or right by steering system, so that wheels of the vehicle or vehicle can be steered. So steering wheel is placed in front of the driver, a nominal or simple thing. So generally, so with the help of this steering, we can provide angular motion of the front wheels to negotiate the turn. To have turn, we require steering. It is required to provide directional stability to vehicle whenever it is moving on a road and we want straight ahead moving of the vehicle. And many vehicles nowadays, the premium model along with the top model of particular brand are equipped with power steering, which uses additional fluid pressure to reduce steering effort. It's whatever steering effort or the energy required to steer vehicle in either left or right direction, that is reduced by using the power steering option. Nowadays, there are some of the big vehicles, heavy transport vehicles, they are also having that power steering options. Accordingly, it is going to reduce the steering effort and it will also reduce the fatigue to the driver. So these power steerings, how it works in the short sentence, it is written: when driver turns the steering wheel, a hydraulic mechanism comes into play to provide most of the efforts needed to turn the wheels. So suppose a preliminary 50 Newton, that much force is required to steer the wheel, and if power steering option is used, it can be reduced up to 30 Newton. So 20% reduction of the efforts that can be allowed with the help of the power steering. So power steering options will reduce the driver's fatigue and it will give easeability in the steering option, in the steering operation. Then next one is front axle. So just I will show that and again we'll move to this. So this one is the front axle. This one is the front axle. Wheels. Here this is the front axle. This is the front axle. Or this one is the front axle. Okay. Now, what is front axle? So, stub axles are mounted at the end of front axle. It is usually a beam, a metal beam. So just like this, just I will change the color. This is front axle, and to this front axle there are small axles, and these are called as the stub axles. This is structure on that stub axles are mounted. Okay, so stub axles are mounted at end of the front axle. So its function is to transfer part of vehicle weight of the vehicle to the wheels through this axle. So front axle performs several functions. As mentioned in the previous sentence, it carries weight of the front of the vehicle. It takes horizontal and vertical loads when vehicle moves on road. It is made up of steel. And what is manufacturing process? It is drop forging method. It is manufactured by employing drop forging method, and it is robust in structure. So it is sturdy, as it is located at the front. As we are controlling the vehicle with the help of the steering, as we need to provide some space for providing the mechanism for the steering, so it should be robust in construction. And which method to manufacture it? That is drop forging. So that is manufacturing method. So it may also ask. Then next one is suspension system. So just I will show, you will get idea about the suspension system. So actually here it is not visible clearly. Okay, so suspension system of automobile. So just I will draw it in side view, as I am not having that image. So this is long member, this is spring, this one is axle, this is wheel, this one is the spring. So suspension system of an automobile that separates wheels and axle assembly from the body. So this one is the wheel, this one is the axle, and this is the spring, which is used to separate the axle and wheel assembly from the body. So this one is the chassis, and above that body is there. So why it is required? It is required to isolate the body of the vehicle from the shocks and vibration generated due to the irregularities on the surface of the road. So you know, road surface is unhevel, H-E-A-V-A-L. Unhevel means it consists of irregularities such as bounce and pit. Bounce means some convex structure, and pits means concave structure on the road. So that unevenness of the road, that is source of shocks and vibration. So generally it is required to isolate shocks and vibration to get transmitted to the body, or it will provide the discomfort to the passenger. And it is also required to maintain the stability of vehicle in pitching, rolling, and when vehicle is in motion. So sometimes on the speed breaker, we are applying the brake, or because of the speed breaker, so there is motion of this axle in upward and downward direction. And as this spring is flexible, so there may be vibrations, and such situations will create pitching, or on the curvature there is rolling action. Rolling means it is about longitudinal axis or axis along the long members of the vehicles. So along with the springs, shock absorbers are provided. What is purpose of shock absorber? In other way, we can call it as a dampers. Other way, we are going to call it as a dampers. Damp means once shock or vibrations are generated due to the irregularities, there will be large vibration, or amplitude of vibration is large. How to decrease that? By using shock absorber, or simply the damper. So damper, the function of damper is to reduce amplitude of the vibration. So that's why along with the spring, shock absorbers are also used to have better comfort for the passengers. So you might have seen such dampers along with the springs are provided. So suspension system is provided on the front as well as rear end of the vehicle. Okay. Up to this, any question to any of the students? Please ask. Sachin?
No, sir.
Okay. Deep Jyoti, any question? Okay. Sachin, speed ahe ka kami karayche ka vadhvaycha? What I need to do?
Nahi sir, speed ahe bara. Mi jyacha ya speed ne gele tar bara hoy.
Ahe tya thik ahe na?
Ha, thik ahe, thik ahe. Ka problem nahi.
Thik ahe, thik ahe. Sunil, roll number 62.
Yes, sir.
Any issue about speed understanding, you can immediately tell.
Okay, sir. Barabar.
No issue?
No, sir.
So while just I am explaining, you can note down the points so that at the end, or just by interrupting me while explaining, you can ask immediately any question, or any of the student. No issue. Okay, should I proceed then for next bit?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now next bit is related to the types of vehicle drive layout, or another words why I am giving. So you should have that word bank, and it is useful nowadays because of this MCQ type based examination. So types of vehicle drive layout. So already we have seen that chassis. So once again I will show that, because that is important. Okay, so this is the chassis. Now engine is placed at front and drive is given to the rear wheel. If this engine is placed at rear and drive is given to rear, so whatever space available on the chassis frame, so usability affects. So manufacturer try to use maximum space available on chassis frame. Now if engine is placed at the front, radiator is at the front, it can easily get air, and it will increase the cooling efficiency. And now, if engine is provided on the rear, so there will be less cooling efficiency. Such advantages and disadvantages we need to study just by studying vehicle drive layout. Now, engine is placed at the front and this much space is available. So here we can create a structure. Here we can create a chamber to load the goods. Here we can provide the seats to for the passenger vehicles. So based on how various components, how major components of the vehicles, of the vehicle placed on the chassis frame, there are different types of chassis drive layout. Okay, so types of vehicle drive layout. Here, what is the function of this vehicle drive layout? So again, you can have different ideas. So how to utilize the space available on the chassis frame. So again, a simple vehicle drive layout. So what is the function for that? It converts one or multiple form of energy to mechanical energy, and that is used in vehicle wheels for propulsion. So best example is hybrid cars. Now CNG. If CNG is not available, if petrol is used to convert to get the mechanical energy. So that combustion of fuel is going to take place, and we are utilizing that for as an mechanical energy. So again, if CNG is available, so that for is converted into mechanical energy, and that is used for the vehicle propulsion. So this layout includes engine, transmission, and the drive train. So major components: engine, that is a prime mover; transmission, it includes first component clutch, second gearbox, then universal joint, propeller shaft, final drive, differential, and wheels. So major components are shown. So fuel consumption, emission release, comfort, weight of the vehicle depends upon powertrain's efficiency, function, and design. Efficiency, function, and design. Now, whatever chassis layout I have shown, what we have seen here, engine is provided at the front. Here it is radiator. And now we can see these aspects wherein you can check. So fuel consumption, emission release means engine is placed at the front and emission release at the rear side. Then comfort, with respect to the comfort. So these aspects we should relate with respect to the vibration and the weight transfer. So how that powertrain is efficient and how it efficiently functioning and how various components are placed. So for small cars, which type of drive is used? Front engine, front wheel drive. Engine is placed at front and drive is given to the front wheel, and we are going to get fuel economy. We are having mileage, more mileage in case of the small cars, and that type of drive is beneficial to get the more mileage. Where engine is placed at the front and drive is given to the rear, there is mileage is less as compared to the front engine, front wheel drive. So you should remember this third one aspect is important, and these sub aspects are important. So fuel consumption, emission release, comfort and weight of the vehicle depends upon powertrain, how powertrain is efficient, how efficiently components are located, whether those are compatible with other system, how they are functioning, and what is their design. Now, for suppose we can take example of clutch, so single plate clutch, and if we want to transmit more torque, then we need to increase the diameter of the plate. Instead of that diameter, if we are going to increase number of plates, we can have compact size of clutch. So that is design aspect. One example I have told you, right? So while designing the various components, we need to consider, now for large clutch, space requirement will be more. Unnecessarily weight is going to be increased. If weight is going to be increased, mileage is going to be decreased. So such aspects we need to consider. That means all these aspects are based on how various components are located on the chassis frame. Okay, now based on that, there are various types. First one is front engine rear wheel drive, and we are going to call it as a conventional weight, conventional weight. So whatever old cars, whatever Jeeps nowadays available, that Mahindra Bolero, so front engine rear wheel drive. So you can see this one is the front of the vehicle, this one is the axle, these are the front wheels, these are the rear wheels, here it is engine. Now everybody is knowing engine is nothing but the prime mover. This one is the gearbox or torque converter in case of automatic transmission. This one is the transmission. Here we can call this gearbox as a transmission box also. And this whole system from this transmission up to this is called as a transmission system. And this one is the drive shaft, differential, and the drive axle. What you are observing? Drive axle means these are taking part in providing or in generating tractive effort, in generating tractive effort. So here itself, I will show you. This is side view. This is side view. Now the tractive effort is available. The force is available to drive vehicle at the contact between these rear wheels with the road. Itha fakta tractive force available asnar aaye aplyakade, because it is front engine rear wheel drive. And whatever ability of these rear wheels, ability of these rear wheels to transmit the tractive effort available at this point to the front, that is called as a traction. So here we can get the tractive effort. So that's why it is called as a drive axle. We are not calling front axle as a drive axle. So it is dead axle. It is dead axle. हे जर व्हील फिरले तरच व्हेकल पुढे जाणार आहे, हे फिरले तर व्हेकल पुढे जाणार नाही, याला आपल्याला फिरवावं लागेल. सो वी नीड टू रोटेट दिस. हाउ टू रोटेट? बाय प्रोव्हाइडिंग ड्राइव, राइट? सो यू शुड नॉट टेक एक्झाम्पल, सर व्हेनेवर वी आर स्टेपिंग डाऊन, त्या केसमध्ये न्यूट्रल जर टाकली तर गाडी पुढे जाते. So that is different case. So to have or to say drive axle, those axles should be powered. So engine power available, gearbox, transmission, drive shaft, and here it is power is flowing, no direct connection with the engine to this front axle. So therefore this axle is called as a live axle and this axle is called as a dead axle. So such type of drive, such type of front engine rear wheel drive, so here you can see how engine is mounted. Figure simple vatte, so you are observing here figure is very simple, but you need to identify its characteristics. What are the characteristics of front engine rear wheel drive? What you are observing, engine is placed in longitudinal direction. So longitudinally mounted engine 1, 2, 3, and 4, and here you can see transverse direction perpendicular to the longitudinal direction. So in case of front engine rear wheel drive, engine is placed dash 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 longitudinally, transversely. Such type of question may be asked during the interview or maybe for the MCQ. So engine is placed or engine is mounted longitudinally on the front of the vehicle and driving the rear wheels via drive linkage. This one is the linkage, and through the differential or the final drive and the differential axis. So this is a very simple layout or simple design and having good handling characteristics. Why good handling characteristics? There is no complications. Simply engine is placed at front, drive is given to the rear, and you can check this. Everything is at the front. Why I have shown this figure? Because you should know what is good handling characteristics. When you open the bonnet of front engine front wheel drive, that is for the car, you are observing that there is too many components. We need to identify these components. But in case of front engine rear wheel drive, this one is simple layout, good handling characteristics. We can just easily observe the components. So it allows this type of drive allows ample room for transmission in the center of the vehicle. It also avoids mechanical complexities associated with the transmitting power to the front wheels. So mechanical complexity, so in case of the front engine front wheel drive, too much components are there at one end. Here what you are observing, engine at front and transmission system through this center line, and at the end there is differential. So one heavy component at the front, another heavy component at the rear. So it also gives more stability to the vehicle, right? So this layout is more suitable in case of the vehicles which has to carry large loads, large passenger load, large good loads. So that's why medium transport vehicles or medium transport vehicles are using such layout. So what is the reason? So here you can have another example, another characteristics with respect to this. So whatever weight transfer. That is one of the characteristics. Whenever we are going to accelerate the vehicle, so primarily we are accelerating the engine, and again transmission is having more acceleration. Because of that, whatever weight of the engine which is placed at the front side, there is weight transfer, and that weight, some weight is transferred on this rear axle, and that additionally benefits to have more tractive effort. So whatever wheels at the rear, they will have more adhesion with the road, or more good connect with the road. And in other words, we can call it as a weight transfer to the rear of the vehicle during the acceleration, which increases load on the rear wheel and in turn increases grip with the road. So accordingly, it is having more grip. So we can now discuss regarding the advantages of this type of drive. So even weight distribution, what is reasoning? Engine is placed at front, differential is placed at rear, even weight distribution, improved traction. What is reason for that? Weight transfer during acceleration. Again, we can have less steering radius. In other words, we can call it as a less turning circle. Why less turning circle? You are not observing any complex component here. So this is layout. Actually, steering system is there, but steering system only is there, no other component. So we can have less turning radius for such type of drive. Then again, we can see another advantage for this. Just you should check this. There is somewhat complexity. There is somewhat complexity. And what here observing? There is empty space. There is empty space. Steering will be there. So here, because of more even weight distribution, so it is having better handling characteristics during dry condition. So what is the reason for that? So there will be even load on front wheels and the rear wheels. Again, it has better braking experience. And what is the reason for that? Again, even weight distribution. It is sturdy layout. And the packaging or placing constraints of all the components which are essential for propulsion of the vehicle. Again, here itself we can inspect engine, transmission system, propeller shaft, or the drive shaft. Here all components are on the front axle. So this is somewhat complicated to inspect. So why I have shown? Just we need to have the comparison, easier for inspect, easier for repair, easier for any adjustment with respect to the engine, easier for clutch, easier for gearbox maintenance. And it is also useful to provide more powerful engine. Also useful to provide more powerful engine. That means if you want to provide more powerful engine as a primer on the vehicle, we should select front engine rear wheel drive. So that's why in some of the vehicles, some of the brands, they are manufacturing and they are selecting front engine rear wheel drive. So here you should remember the layout, and if descriptive type question is are there, then you can draw such simple figure. Now again, what is the disadvantage of such type of drive? So for each and every design, there are some advantages as well as some disadvantages. With respect to this, we can discuss some of the disadvantages of this front engine rear wheel drive. So here we can see that decreased interior space. Now you can compare directly ambassador car and modern cars. Immediately you are going to identify what is decreased interior space. So decreased interior space means in case of such type of drive, we are having less leg room. So what is meaning of less leg room? So whatever space provided to place our leg while sitting, that is less in case of such type of vehicle in which such type of drive layout is used. So whatever this transmission system or this longitudinal flow of power, we required tunnel. So you might have observed at the center there is one part extruding from the leveled lower space of the vehicle. Then again, as it consists of components placed in the longitudinal direction, though it is less complex, but whatever components used in this are larger, it also increases weight, because this one is the drive shaft, this one is the transmission system, this is the engine, this one is the differential, and you just compare with this. Everything, it is in small unit. Engine, this one is torque converter, or timing you can call it as gearbox, and this one is the transaxle. This is nothing but the whole transmission system. Everything is included in this casing. So in case of the front engine rear wheel drive, the weight is more, and accordingly it is having increased weight characteristics. And it also have higher initial purchase cost. So cost is also more because of large components. So that's why to provide a car with low cost so that customer can attract many manufacturer or all the car manufacturer, SUV, and sedan car, hatchback car, everywhere this is not used. Which type of drive is used? Front engine, front wheel drive, because it will decrease initial purchase cost because of reduction in the components. So this will add more cost. So while selecting engine to provide car at lower prices, we need to decrease the cost. How to decrease? Just by selecting this second type of the vehicle drive layout. Now let us move towards this second one, front engine, front wheel drive. So already we have seen the first one. Now that is also required to refer. Why required to refer? Because just we are comparing. Now here all other things I am not going to repeat, just we'll discuss simple advantages and the disadvantages with respect to this and some of the construction related characteristics. So engine is placed transversely or parallel to the front axle. This you should remember. Other things are same. Now here this front axle is live axle and this rear one is dead axle. Here it is written rear dead axle, and in the previous one this one is the drive axle, this one is the dead axle. Here this is dead axle and this one is the live axle, and here it is written front drive axle. Now with respect to this, what are the advantages that we are going to discuss? So in case of the previous one, we have seen propeller shaft, we have seen differential at the back, and here what you are observing only the casing, which includes the transmission box, differential and other essential transmission components. So with respect to this type of drive, we can have low floor, so ground clearance can be decreased. So suppose in the side view, this is the wheel and this is body part. So we can decrease the floor height to increase the roll number 26. Mute your mic. Hello? Roll number 26. Okay. Sumit, any question?
No, sir.
Huh?
No, sir.
Then why you have raised a hand? No issue. Okay. Okay, so you should take care of your mic setting. Otherwise, if somebody is not muting and abruptly unmuting, then I need to remove it immediately to avoid disturbance. Okay, so here with respect to such type of drive, we can have low floor. Why low floor? Absence of propeller shaft and differential at back. So again, for this you should check this diagram. Okay, now here this is front engine rear wheel drive, front engine rear wheel drive. So this one is the differential and this is the propeller shaft. So that's why ground clearance with respect to this, we need to provide more. So here we can have low space, low floor or less ground clearance. Again, here engine, all the transmission system is placed on the front wheels. Therefore, more adhesion or grip is there. grip is there, then it is having less cost. What is why less cost is there? Because clutch, gearbox and differential are provided in one casing, that is transaxle, that is called as a transaxle. So that's why it is having less cost. Then you can see the space available in the top view. From this we can have one conclusion with respect to the interior space. Since the powertrain, that means the transmission system, is a single unit and it is near to the engine, and there is no requirement to provide additional space on the chassis frame for any other component as well as for drive shaft tunnel or the rear differential. Accordingly, the interior space is going to be increased in case of the front engine front wheel drive. So what we are observing, so for car, whatever the cars nowadays, and you can see the ambassador car, that old version. So interior, just by having experience, so you can see the interior space and the construction of or how the placing of various components. So interior space means it will increase the volume inside the body. Volume inside the body. Now vehicle terminology, right? So as a mechanical engineer, you should not ask any of that person in the showroom kiti jaga shillak ahe. So you can ask that person how much boot space is available. So whatever space available as a dicky, so we generally call it as a dicky in the practical language. So generally it is counted in the volume unit. So again, as we need to provide one unit for the transaxle or for the various components such as clutch, gearbox and the drive shaft connectivity, so less component usually means low weight, and accordingly as weight is decreased, it has improved fuel efficiency. And what is the reason for that? Less weight. Again, less weight means cost, less cost. So we are decreasing the weight means again we can have decreased cost, less material components, less installation complexity. Overall we can say like that. And finally we can conclude with respect to this drive that it has improved drivetrain efficiency. Improved drivetrain efficiency. Here you can see engine, gearbox, transmission, then drive shaft, differential, final drive differential, and finally the wheels. And what here we are observing, after the transaxle, after the transmission box, the drive shaft directly connected to the wheel. Drive shaft directly connected to the wheel. What it indicates? It indicates that there is direct connection between engine and the transaxle, which will reduce mass and mechanical inertia of the drivetrain. And ultimately, it allows to get greater fuel economy. It allows to get greater fuel economy. So that's why such type of drive is used in the cars. Now, what are the disadvantages? You can just check the disadvantages with respect to this, and that is required. So, what are the disadvantages with respect to this? You can see that there is reduced tractive effort. So, already I have told what is tractive effort. The force available at the point between contact point between road and the tire, and that force we are going to call it as a tractive effort. Now, in case of this, please see the screen. Front engine rear wheel drive, tractive effort is available here, at the rear end, and whenever there is acceleration, weight transfer from front to rear, that will increase more grip. Now, in this case, where tractive effort is available, at the point contact point between the front wheel and the road. So that tractive effort is available, and that tractive effort is reduced. Available tractive effort is reduced while accelerating the vehicle. So during the acceleration, so weight shifts back, giving more traction to the rear wheels. So tractive effort is available here. And what is traction? Two terms samjun gya. Tractive effort means available force. Kashamulo honar hai? Because of the transmission system and whatever engine we are providing or generally provided. And traction means ability of front wheels to transmit tractive effort to the rear wheel. कशामध्ये ह्या टाइप्सच्या ड्रायव्हिंगमध्ये. आणि ह्या केसमध्ये ट्रॅक्शनची डेफिनेशन काय असणार आहे? ॲबिलिटी ऑफ रिअर व्हील्स टू ट्रान्समिट ट्रॅक्टिव्ह एफर्ट टू द फ्रंट व्हील, दॅट इज ट्रॅक्शन. सो डेफिनेशन इज गोइंग टू बी चेंज, और सिंपली जनरल डेफिनेशन, ॲबिलिटी ऑफ व्हील्स टू ट्रान्समिट ट्रॅक्टिव्ह एफर्ट फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू द अनदर, दॅट इज द जनरलाइज डेफिनेशन फॉर द traction from one wheel to the another wheel, that is nothing but the traction. So here, reduced tractive effort because of the acceleration, and that's why in some of the racing cars, so you can take example of the racing car. So there we can you can see that. So that is one of the main reason why nearly all racing cars are rear wheel drive. Racing car madhe asha type cha vehicle layout vaparla jat nahi. Why it is not used? Because it reduces tractive effort. So this is the main reason in why this type of drive is not used in racing car. So which type of drive is used in racing car? This one is the used. This is used. Okay. There is one more disadvantage of this type of drive, that is reduced traction on gradient. So wherever that stepped the road, whenever vehicle moving in a hilly terrain, there is gradient, and sometimes there is reduced traction on road on which snow is spreaded or ice covered roadways. In that case, there is reduced traction, and it also has increased turning circle. Why increase the turning circle? So you should take example of ambassador car and current car. So whatever presently available car, you should compare that only. So space required to turn. I am not discussing sedan car and hatchback car. Any two cars with similar category, we can compare. So these are the advantages and disadvantages with respect to the front engine, front wheel drive. Any questions? Any questions? Any questions so that I can proceed further? Sachin?
No, sir. No, sir. No question.
Okay. So, next one. This is rear engine, rear wheel drive. Rear engine, rear wheel drive. A schematic, three-dimensional schematic is shown on the left hand side. So this is example of one of the car, Polo RX, and the same type of drive layout is used for the Nano car. So you can check out this three-dimensional image. So RR means rear engine, rear wheel drive. So those are the short form. Okay. Here you can see this is the engine and this one is the transmission. Similar to the front wheel drive, it is shown. So blue indicates these are the drive wheels and this is the direction of running of the vehicle. Okay. So you can check out. So when engine is placed at front, there is mechanical complexity. When engine is placed at rear, there is mechanical complexity. So what are the advantages and the disadvantages? So in case of such vehicles, we can have better vision of the road. Better vision of the road. Engine पाठीमागच्या बाजूला असल्यामुळे इथं समोर आपण लोअर तुमचं बॉनेटचं लोअर हाईट करू शकतो. प्लस ड्रायव्हर इज हॅव्हिंग क्लिअर विजन ऑफ द रोड आहे, सिमिलर टू अवर ट्रक्स बसेस, राईट? एकदम काचेच्या जवळ. पण फ्रंट इंजिन फ्रंट व्हील ड्राईव्ह मध्ये काय बघितलंय? व्हॉट वी हॅव सीन, इंजिन इज प्लेस्ड इन फ्रंट ऑफ द ड्रायव्हर, त्याच्यामुळे पुढचा स्पेस थोडा युटिलाइज करता येत नाही आपल्याला. त्याच्यामुळं इन सम ऑफ द कार्स वी आर हॅविंग लेस विजन ऑफ द रोड अँड दॅट्स वाय ड्रायव्हिंग डिफिकल्टीज आर देअर. नाव यू कॅन टेक एक्झाम्पल ऑफ द नॅनो कार and similar to this Polo RX. So though that vehicle is having less cost, but it is having more clear vision of the road ahead and it will increase the driver's control. Okay. Then what will be the disadvantage for this? Engine is placed at rear, so there is less cooling efficiency. Less cooling efficiency. Ultimately, it is going to have less cooling effect to the engine. And normally, such vehicles are having heating issues. And sometimes we need to stop. So they cannot run up to 500 kilometers in a day or 1000 kilometers in a day. So continuous driving is not possible with such cases. Again, with respect to this rear engine, rear wheel drive, if we are going to take example of city buses, what will happen? So just I will draw one small figure here. So this is the city bus, and here engine compartment and all the drive system. Okay, what you are observing here, driver's cabin, this space can be used for passenger seat, this for passenger seat, and above the engine also we can utilize the space. So rear engine, rear wheel drive, we can utilize the space above the engine as well in case of the city bus. Now if you are going to take another example of the city bus where engine is provided at the front, here it is driver, so this much space is wasted. Here you can see driver's cabin and the space over the engine. So here only that space is utilized for driver. Here we can utilize for driver as well as for the passengers. So utilization of maximum space available on the vehicle layer, on the chassis frame, is made effectively in case of rear engine, rear wheel drive, in case of the city bus, as well as in case of the cars. So we can have luggage. So this is the top of the engine, and once this we are going to close, we can get some space to provide a luggage on this. So we can have additional luggage on the top of the engine, or generally which we are going to call it as a carriage, somewhat small. Okay, so this is about the rear engine, rear wheel drive. It is not commonly used. For few models it is available. Okay, now this is for today. So tomorrow we will take this all wheel drive, in which we are going to study what is part time, what is full time drive. We'll discuss the characteristics and various components, additional components which are provided in case of all wheel drive. So that we are going to study. Okay, so now today intentionally I took lecture in the morning session because I was just observing that many students are not attending the lectures in the afternoon session and strength was very less. And today around 37 to 38 students are present. So already I took your attendance after your login. Now you are not required to put any roll number in the chat box. And if somebody, so you should track your attendance as well. So it is my request, all the students attend lectures of all the subjects. So for RAC, more numericals are there. You should think on your point of view, not the university and multiple choice question and descriptive type question. So whatever you are going to get by studying this subject, that will help you in future. Otherwise, because of this online type of examination, because of this online type of examination, that means MCQ type. So you are